السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Now in this tutorial we are going to complete our cell form. Until now we have just completed. Until now we have just completed our cell form save and print button, but we have not just completed our print. So we have to complete delete, update, remove and edit. And we are just going to copy and paste from purchase form. As you know, we have just completed our purchase form. So just copy and paste all the content of the purchase form. Here it is. Just copy sale form. Remove, it is for removing the item in the data grid view. Edit. Now this is for, I'll show you example. It will remove the selected row and it will represent all the item into the text box, combo box. Just I'll show you. Now just run it. Yes, the password was user Amir and password was 123. Sometimes it happened like I just forgot. 123. Now here it is bin, sale bin. Now if you have written something, and let's see, local customer date. Now it is for just we have clicked this. It is for removing the selected row of the data grid view. Just remove it. Now it is for editing. Just select and it will come to the text box. Now we have to complete this delete and update button and view button. Button. Just copy and paste the content of the purchase form and we have to change the table name and just copy all the content. Copy. We have to change the name of the purchase to sale. You could you can write the bracket closing and opening to the table name and also the column name. It will look some standard. It is vendor name. It is not a vendor name. Let's check for the sale and sale item. Customer name. It is not a purchase date, it is a sale date. Yes, sale date. And total number You don't want to zoom. Yes, sim. Now purchase item table. Sale item. Yes, now everything is similar. Just look this PID product weight amount. Yes, now everything is similar. Just run it. First, we'll check only 10,001 invoice number is present, so just click on it. Yes, we have to write down 10,001. Yes, everything is represented. Yes, the total amount, quantity, here it is, product ID, product name, quantity, weight amount. What was the error? It is represented 2 times, product ID. Just close it. Product ID and product. It is product, yeah. 2 times. Now just run it. Now everything is correct. Product ID, product, quantity, rate, and amount, total amount. Now we have to use delete button, update button, close. Just copy into the container of the purchase. Delete. Copy. Let's paste it. Now first of all, this is for increase the stock. Whenever you delete the sale bill, the stock will directly will increase. The quantity of the stock will increase, and this here sale with sale table for deleting the invoice from the sale table, and this is for deleting the invoice from sale item from the two of the table. Just use it if you like, use dragon, otherwise nothing will happen. I will delete invoice number 1000, 10,001. View first. I will view, then delete. Actually, we have to use option that will you want? Do you want to delete? And here there is no option. First of all, I will make an option. If Metro MD. Now this will ask, do you want to delete? And this for message box title delete box, message box icon and message box button. The message box icon, message box dot. Message box icon dot question mark and message box button, yeah, button dot okay, okay or cancel, just do it like this. Dialog is equal to okay. Here we are using OK cancel, not we are using yes or no. So use here OK. This pair of use something is missing. System dot integer. Just do one thing. Find dialog dialog. Here it is. Yes, everything is the same. Message box dot show saved. Just copy the content. So the Metro message box is not supporting, I think. Yes, no, just use here this. Yes, everything is good. And just we have to use, make the first block comment it is true. So just come to the top. And you use else. just copy and paste this. No, we don't require this. Just run it. View. And when we click, it will ask the question. Delete box. Now see, this is the title name. Delete box. And this is the question. Do you want to delete? And you have to use OK or cancel. If you want to use OK and cancel, just select OK. And it is deleted successfully. Just we will check it. Yes, it is deleted. 1001. Yes, yeah, it is. So, it is the item and the seal. Now, here we have to use OK and cancel. Here it is. OK. Cancel. And you have to provide one message box. Do not use the table. Same. Clear item. The user will understand everything is deleted. Now, update. Let's go to the purchase update, copy all the content, save. Here is update button, just build. Now here you have to change the table name and the column name. Here it is purchased to sale, vendor name to, here it is vendor customer name. Purchase to sale date. Invoice. Stock ID, it is correct. Stock, here stock name. Now we don't require this. I'll teach you next time because it is complicated. It is some logically. Just commit it. Just we require this much. Update custom name. Just run it. No. Which record is remaining? Customer 1002 demo 2. Now we are going to change name. Customer demo 2 to view demo 2 to I and I. This is local customer. Just updating. And update option also you have to require a question message box. Do you want to update or not? So just close it. Yeah, just for go to the option. Just copy. And paste over here. We will require this code next time. I will explain you why to use this code. Here, do you want to delete? Do you want to update? Update. Update. And yeah, okay. Purchase to sale. Take it into the inner block. Update it. Successfully. Just run it. If you have to use one of the option, clear option. Clear. Just check it out. New invoice. Copy this. I'll show what will happen. Go to the update. Whenever the clear function will execute, after it will clear all the value and it will represent the new invoice number. Because when we save or delete or update any of the invoice number, after that all the value should be clear and the next invoice number should be represent in this form. Now just click view. I'm changing it to local CSQML customer. Updating. Yes, okay. Yes, something error. And what was the error? Here it is. I am VOI. VOICE. Invoice. Okay, update successfully. The clear function, there is no clearing function, clearing code for data grid view, name, and this total amount. So we have to use that. I'll show you. Go to definition, data grid. What are the data grid name? Properties. Metro grid one. Dot rows. Dot clear. Here it was in name. Vendor to change it to customer. CUSQM customer name. Okay. Now this total amount is remaining. Total amount. Just click Ctrl F and search Xelia clear. TOT total amount text dot clear. It will clear all the value. No, we don't require this. TOT total amount of text is equal to 0.0, otherwise it will create the error. No, just go to it. Yeah, I'll just click to update. Yes. Now you can see everything is the data grid period is clear. The total amount of 0. Just we have forgotten local means the customer name. Just click Ctrl F to find clear. Clear item. Now we will make a clear all. A new function. Clear, clear all. Just copy on this. So let's say customer name dot text. Okay. Just go to delete button where we have used clear item. We just use clear all. Go to the save button. Here also we have to use a question. Copy, paste in. It's too much big. I just run it. is to click on this updating. Okay, now you can see this is the standard way. The customer will understand our item is updated and saved successfully. Now we'll just save another customer one. Save and print. Yes, yes, the coding. Yes, what was the error? Now I'll show you. Because when you click view button, if ds dot table dot 0, rows dot count 0, else why we are using this condition, because if the invoice number does not exit, it will show the message. Invoice does not exist. One of my subscribers asked me a question that it is giving an error whenever if we enter any of the invoice number. So just now the second error was there, it was making disable save and print button. So what was the error? Just we'll check it. Yes, here it is. Whenever we click a view button, it is the condition was that invoice button dot enable is equal to false, save button is equal to. What we have to do is copy in, paste in, go to the coding, control F, just paste over here. Whenever you click, it will enable. Now I'm just writing any of the number. Invoice did not exist. Yes. Again the condition is running. Here we have to use the condition. Just clear on. Just copy and paste over here. Sorry, over here. Whenever the true statement block will run. Yes, 1000 or 10003. The investment network access. Yes. Let's save it. Yes, the same but not saveable. Customer 1. Just press to alter S. Whenever you say alter S, it will go to the S button. Sorry, cancel. Yes, we have used, we have not changed the save button message box. Save successfully. Yes, just look out. Yes, 1003 customer 1. Customer, yes, we have just have to change the message box name. Go to the save and print button. Yes, here it is. Change to save and use question mark. Here also, save. Now everything is completed. Now we have to now just sale print and sale bill and sale report is remaining. So in the next option we are going to continue sale report and sale print.